we can also give the systematic naming to carboxylic acid using IUPAC nomenclature system. The name of carboxylic acid is derived from the name of parent alkane by replacing E with oic acid. Now, in this compound, we have one carboxyl group. So let me show that. So this is the carboxyl group. While giving the numbering to this carboxylic acid, at that time, we must start the numbering to that carbon in which carboxylic group is there. It means that we must give the number 1 to this carbon of carbonyl or the carboxyl group. And then we have 2 as well as 3. It means that if you consider the alkane at that time, you will notice that the prop will be prefix and ANE would be the suffix. But while giving the IUPAC name to carboxylic acid, at that time, this E should be replaced with oic acid. That should be replaced with oic acid. So it means that the IUPAC name of this compound will become propanoic acid. Propanoic acid. Now let us take the another example where some more substituents are present. Let me draw the structure like this. So let us have the C double bond OH group. Let me put one carbon-carbon double bond like this. Here is one substituent CH3 and one more substituent Br means bromine. While giving the IUPAC name of this compound, at that time we must start the numbering to the carbon from carboxylic group. So this will become 1, so this will become 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. It means that we have 6 carbon atoms and therefore hex will be the prefix. So let me write it. Hex will be prefix. Here you can see that we have carbon-carbon double bond between carbon number 3 and 4. It means that we must write E and E. And this double bond is present at position 3. So we must write 3-hex in. But this is the carboxylic acid. It means that E should be replaced with oic acid. In this compound, we have 2 substituents. So at position number 2, methyl group is present. And at position number 5, bromine is present. So 5-bromo. Now, while writing the IUPAC name for this compound, we have to consider all these things and then we have to write down the final IUPAC name. So this will become, now is between these 2 substituents, this B will come first in alphabetical order as compared to this M. So we must write 5-bromo. 5-bromo. Then we have 2-methyl, 2-methyl, trihexenoic acid, Now let us take some interesting example. In some carboxylic acid, it is possible to have the 2 carboxylic groups. So let me draw the structure like this. So let us write one carboxylic group over here. Then we have the structure like this. So there is one more carboxylic group over here. Let me put one substituent at this position. So this is CH3. Now while writing the IUPAC name of this compound, we must start with the numbering to the carbon of carboxylic group. But here we have two carboxylic groups. So this is the one and that one is another one. So in this case, we have to take care that the substituted carbon should get the lowest number. So we must start the numbering from right hand side towards the left hand side. So this will become 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Now here you can see that the total number of carbon atoms are 5. And here we have two carboxylic groups are present in this compound. When such type of situation is there at that time, the name of this alkane, that is 5 carbons, means pentane, it will remain as it is. So we must write it as a pentane. Here two carboxyl groups are present, so we must write the prefix as a dioic acid. Also, we have to take care about this substituent. So we have this methyl group at position number 2. So we must write 2-methyl pentane dioic acid. Now let us have another example of the carboxylic acid. If you have any cyclic compound which is attached to carboxyl group, so let me draw the structure. Now here cyclohexane is attached to C double bond OH. In such type of compounds, we have to write down the substituted compound's name. So here cyclohexane is present. So we must write cyclohexane. Cyclohexane. And then we must end up with carboxylic acid. Carboxylic acid. Now let us take one more compound with aromatic carboxylic acid. So in this compound we have benzene ring which is attached to carboxylic group. So we have double bonds like this and C double bond OH. Here benzene is attached to this carboxyl group. It means that the basic compound will become benzoic acid. Let me write one substituent. So here we can write the OH. So while writing the IUPAC name of this compound, at that time we must start the numbering to this carbon first. And then we must start with this 2. It means that at position number 2 we have hydroxyl group. So we must start the IUPAC name of this compound like 2-hydroxy benzoic acid.